Johnathon Rangel coming out to some M&M representing Fresno, California. It's his debut fight here. Don't really know much about him. We talked to him in the back. He's super excited about the opportunity to showcase his skills right now.
When I talked to him, he didn't really have much to say, but he's a good kid.
Yeah.
I don't want to call him a kid because does he have his age here? This is the walkout I would want.
This is the walkout song.
But he said he's just ready. Like a lot of these other fighters, he said, "I'm just ready. I wanna go in there and fight."
Yeah.
Real simple. Mom spaghetti. I feel like this is the signature walkout song that everyone would love to have, but it's almost not.
But very few can pull it off.
Yeah, you gotta win if you come out to this. If you don't win and come out to this song,
this is the underdog song.
You gotta make it worth it. If you pick this song, you better come out and win by knockout. If you ask me. But this is the epitome of why a fight is connected to a song. It's pretty much saying you're nervous, but you're still gonna
put it on the line.
Exactly. He's ready, man. I love it. I love to see it.
Johnathon Rangel making his first entrance into the cage ever.
Fighting in the blue corner. I did ask fighters, what do they specialize in or want to focus on in the fight? And he said he just wants to come in and he wants to show a little bit of everything.
That's been the story of the night. Everywhere, there's been no just like pure stand-up fight.
Yeah, yeah. And there is, as the fights go on, there's going to be some fighters that have told me, I'm a striker, I'm striking. You know, some said I have a wrestling background, I'm going to the ground, you know?
Yeah. I think that comes with more time, more experience. They're going to figure out where they feel more comfy, especially when you have the pressure of the crowd and the lights under you.
Yeah.
Braydon Carlon here representing the Shoot MMA. Once again, Brian Travers' gym. Very, very well decorated coach. He looks ready. He looks in shape. He's grooving his way to the ring through Red Hot Chili Peppers right now.
I love this song. This is a classic. When I was in the back talking to everybody, he didn't have his gloves on yet, so I thought he was part of someone's team, so I didn't get to interact with him, but he definitely looks ready. He's prepared. He just embraced his coach. He's about to make his way into the ring, and this looks like one of those fights that you're going to see both kind of give us a show right now.
You know, coming from me, I'm a musician. I've played all over the world. It's weird what songs people find hype.
Yeah.
I was coming out to fight, I wouldn't think Red Hot Chili Peppers, but he is just over the moon with this song right now and just in the zone.
Yeah. The thing I love about this is that, like what you just said, a song choice, it kind of shows who they are.
Yeah.
Did you ever see Mike Perry coming out? You wanted to come out to Halo, like the Halo game song, theme song, but it ended up being Beyonce Halo, and he said, "We're gonna go with it."
We're gonna go with it.
Yeah, one of the best moments in ring walk history, if you ask me.
I like Mickey Gall coming out to "Oh Mickey, You're So Fine" when he beat up CM Punk.
That was a good one. I do remember that too. I do remember that.
Introducing first. Out of the blue corner, sponsored by NutriZone, a debuter weighing in at 145 pounds, Johnathon Rangel.
Both these guys coming in at 145 on the dot, professional, making the weight you're supposed to make.
And out of the red corner.
The fun part about this is I love seeing people what they're doing prior to the fight happening.
Just what kind of headspace they're trying to put themselves in.
Johnathon is kind of just staying to himself. You can tell he's zoning himself out. He knows he's fighting someone with a little bit more of a crowd.
He's talking to himself. He's hyping himself up right now. I wonder what he's saying to himself.
And you know the unique thing about fighting? No matter how hype you are coming in, no matter how many people come to support you, at the end of the day, when that door closes, it's you two, and skills speak for themselves, you know?
Oh, big front kick right away.
Right away, front kick. Push them back. Oh, big right hook. Another big right.
Big exchange right here. These guys are coming out heavy.
Whoa, we was not expecting that. Braydon with a takedown against the cage. You have Johnathon against the cage, and he's trying to get a better position to get up, but it looks like Braydon is strong.
He's trying to gift wrap that arm and go for some top heavy ground and pound.
It's because that leg is locked by his right.
He's not letting him out of the half guard.
He can't get out of that.
It's just annoying rabbit punches from the top right now.
This reminds me of Khabib. Oh.
The ref did not like what he was seeing. Johnathon protesting right away.
His arm was caught. I get it to an extent, but
ref is trying to protect him.
I really wish that they would have let that go on.
I would have liked to see about another 20 seconds to see where that went.
Yeah. So let me elaborate on what the referees were kind of going through in the back. Ed, that there does not need to be a tap out or a knockout for them to stop the fight. Because, one, this is not a professional bout. It's sanctioned by, you know, a professional record being brought by the end result. So the big thing about these fights is the referees, again, protecting the fighters. Unfortunately, Johnathon came out blazing hot.
He came out game.
I'm going to be honest. This is probably the most exciting fight of the night to me.
Yeah,
and it's already gone and over.
It was the shortest.
But he I would have loved, like you said, I would have loved to see 20 more seconds.
He came out, Jorge Masvidal, Ben Askren, just was trying to get that flash finish.
Oh, man.
Look at this guy.
He's flicking his bat on the camera.
He likes the way he looks.
Yeah, I wish that we got to see more of that, man.
You just got to love it when there's two dogs in there just ready to go.
Yeah.
Ready for war.
Yeah. Man. What a good fight. I love the way he opened that up. He did something that I don't think he was expecting.
No, that quick front kick right to the solar plexus.
Oh, man. It threw him back against Octagon. And not even that. His first, this is why I would have loved to see it go on. Johnathon threw a beautiful right hand. He doesn't look like a striker, but he had beautiful form and power behind that punch. And then you have Braydon on the other side who exchanged with him. But I would have loved to see more stand-up and strikes and
I
see where
that
went.
I do not feel like that was quite at the end of the road that the ref saw.
And you know when he stopped it, I will say this. He had just got, because it was trapped, kind of sliding out.
Yeah.
He got it on the mat, and then they called it. If they would have allowed that to keep going a bit, he would have been fine.
It definitely, you know, you can crank the shoulder back from there with a trap, but not really from that position.
Man. We're getting a decision right now.
The referee has stopped the fight at 43 seconds of round one. And your winner by TKO.